Kim showed me how to train it to understand my voice. It took a few hours. First, Kim made Alisha to train. Okay, that means how to give voice and how to take printout. How the voices changed as printout or wording in the screen like that. She start first. It took a few hours to Alisha to understand. Now, I use it in class and at home as well. She is using in class as well as in home also. It has made me more independent and I am now able to study on my own. Now, I am doing my Max GCSE. I know my teacher will be proud of me because she is trying to fulfill the wish or the word of the teacher. So, if the teacher come to know she is doing her GCSE, means surely she will be proud of her. Next, I never thought I would be able to do one GCSE in my life, but I am going to do now. This is really achievement, isn't it, no children? And I feel like I want to push myself even further. She wants to go more further. Kim says, technology can help me to do that. It is opening up the world for young disabled people like me. Okay, I think you can understand these lines. Then, there are many different types of technology that can help you. Young disabled person become independent. For example, if someone has very limited movement, they can control a computer screen with eye gaze. Very limited movement means they can't able to walk or they can't able to do their work as a normal person. Limited movements only they'll be having. That persons, they can control the computer screen by their eye gaze. Gaze means staring a place or staring the computer screen. That's only eye gaze. That means when they are reading, they can move from page to page using the pupils of their eyes. See, in eyes we have pupils. By using the pupils, we can move one page to another page without touching or typing anything. They don't need to press a button or anything. Just one person, Kim works with all 42 students here at my school and helps us use technology in different ways. See, in that school, in the disabled student school, Kim was the only one person who trained all the 42 students in their level of different disability. She is amazing. I don't know what would do without her. If she didn't know about Kim means, what will be the life of Alisha? That she also don't know. We would lose out on so many opportunities. I has opened up the world to me. Which has opened up the world to her? The technology has opened up the world to her. The next character we are going to see is David. Okay, he is also a disabled person. Her age is 21 years. 21-year-old David says, technology is very important because it enables me to communicate and be independent, which gives me freedom. These are the words of David. David says, technology is very important because why means it enables me to communicate. Communicate means we are conveying our message to someone and be independent and gives me freedom. By the use of technology only, he feels the freedom. For verbal communication, David uses a liberator communication device which he controls with his eye movements. It has a Bluetooth adapter, so it lets him use any PC or Mac by sending commands through a liberator. So the device which was used by David is liberator communication device. See, he can use this device by his eye movements. Okay, in this liberator communication device, there has a Bluetooth adapter, so he can use any PC or Mac by sending commands through the liberator. It was a great feeling when I learned to use it. It took me a couple of weeks. In the beginning, David also took a couple of weeks to learn the technology. Communicating with people was very difficult before. Before means before knowing the use of liberator communication device. He has an active controller. Active is Act 4 controller, also in the headrest of his chair in his bedroom. Headrest means in the figure you can understand at the back of his head he has one pillow like, that's only headrest. In that he has a controller, Act 4 controller, which means he can control his TV, Blu-ray or music players. By that headrest controller, that means a controller which is in the headrest, he can control his TV, Blu-ray and music players. David was born with atrophied cerebral palsy and attends a specialist school and college. That means he has the disease of atrophied cerebral palsy, and then he studied the schools and colleges also like the special schools only. He has been using a high-tech communication aid since he was 8 years old and has been interested in AAC, that is Augmentative and Alternative Communication and Technology, ever since. See, while he was up to his 8 years old, he has used high-tech communication devices and then he came to know the AAC technology. Okay, Augmentative and Alternative Communication, the meaning of that is we can communicate with others or anybody without speech or word. Okay, that's only Augmentative and Alternative Communication. Augmentative and Alternative Communication means communication method without speech and word. Then, when David first started out with AAC, he used a head switch to access his AAC device running a page-based system, which took lots of navigation and required a lot of effort combined with switching. While he started at first, he used to do lots of navigation. Navigation means here it is not related with some other travel, like he has to investigate, that means he has to study a lot and required a lot of effort combined with switching. See, with the switching, he must try to understand so many nook and corners in that communication method. Now, he uses an echo 2 with echo point, making his selections with a foot switch once he has fixed his gaze on the icon that is required. Now, instead of the headrest, he uses his foot to switch the communicator, that is the method, that is the easiest method for him. Instead of touching the headrest, he is using the foot. Okay, he is using echo 2 communicative system, it is with echo point, which makes the easiest selections by him. He has a smaller communication aid. It has been mounted on his walker. Walker, I think you all knew about walker. The little children are using the walker to practice the walking like that. He was sitting in wheelchair, so that by his walker, he was using that method. It is essential that much of his spare time is spent in the performing arts. Okay, which is essential? The communication method is very essential. The communication aid is very essential for him. David is also a keen sportsman, regularly playing football, bokia, hockey and baseball. He is sitting in wheelchair, but he is a keen sportsman. Which sports is he playing? Football, bokia, hockey and baseball. Bokia is nothing but playing by sitting a wheelchair. You can see through net or somewhere, you can see the picture or the methods of bokia. He is a sports leader and uses his Echo 2 link to an interactive whiteboard to teach PE lessons. Okay, he is a sport leader, as well as he uses his Echo 2 link to an interactive whiteboard to teach PE lessons. PE lessons means nothing but only physical education lessons. Okay, then this is his board, his communicative system. David has 144 icons on the screen that he uses with echo point eye gaze. In this figure, you can observe that it has 144 icons. Okay, when David first tried this access method, his response was, "I like it, it makes me faster. When can I have one?" That means in the beginning he said, "I like it, it makes me faster. Then when I can have like this own, like that." Now David uses his Echo 2 and Echo Point to access the curriculum, study for his GCSE, order food and communicative while he is in restaurants and argue with his brother. You name it, David can communicate it. The meaning of this is, see, in the beginning he used this communicative system for very limited, but at present he is using to find the curriculum as well as study for his GCSE, then ordering food, communicating people while he is in restaurants, and then he can able to argue with his brother also. Okay, see, who is using this communicative system more? David only.